Greetings all, welcome to my video. Trump brings the secret space program out into the open, is disclosure next? President Trump takes over Air Force Space Command. He says he is creating SPA, but that is false. The secret space program has been around for a long, very long time. By Dave Hodges. There is so much volatility going on in America, that the majority of us have overlooked a very important story, and that is a de facto admission of a secret space program, that is militarized. President Trump has been hinting for months, that he was going to create a separate branch of the military, related to outer space, that is being referred to as the Space Force. Trump, in effect, says that he is militarizing space. Trump is publicly giving the Outer Space Treaty the big middle finger, as the treaty is recognized by over 100 nations, including the US. The treaty prohibits military action in space. This announcement came during a June 18, 2018 meeting of the US Space Council, in which President Trump signed his third space policy directive. This directive, on the surface, says that it will manage space traffic, minimize space debris, and monitor orbiting spacecraft. This directive creates the first new US military branch since the Air Force was created in 1947. The mainstream media has ignored this development, for the most part, as well as the independent media. Unfortunately, for the arena of military secrets, the president is not doing a very good job of lying. John Logsdon is the former director of the Space Policy Institute at George Washington University, and he recently stated, "The US military has been very active in space for 60 years, this is not some breaking point of militarizing space." Vicky Sutton, a space law expert, and former assistant director in the White House Science Office, under George W. Bush, stated, "Several recent actions, such as the China maneuver, where they targeted their own satellite to attack, and created thousands of pieces of space debris, in a demonstration of their ability to target a space object, as well as other overtures by other nations, make it essential that we have defensive capability. When I saw the following on Fox News, I instantly recognized this for what it was." From Fox News. While touting successes around the globe, and even suggesting the creation of a new military branch, the Space Force, the president spoke to thousands of military men and women at Marine Corps Air Station Miramar in San Diego, California, Tuesday, following his visit to review border wall prototypes. "We are finally going to lead again. Very soon, we're going to Mars. You wouldn't be going to Mars if my opponent won. You wouldn't even be thinking of it," Trump said, in a swipe at Hillary Clinton. That's when the president went on to introduce his new national strategy for space. "Space is a war-fighting domain, just like the land, air, and sea," Trump said. "We may even have a space force, we have the air force, we'll have the space force, you know, the army, the navy." He added, "I said, maybe we need a new force, I was not really serious, but now I'm thinking that's a great idea. We're making a space force. Tremendous." On the surface, President Trump is going to bring the secret space program, militarized, out of the shadows of secrecy. He also plans to eliminate its black budget funding, and make the program a line item, with presidential and congressional oversight. "I was told this was coming, I just did not believe it. As I have previously published, I knew about the secret space program since 1983, when my father told me of it when his health began to fail. However, I could not reveal anything publicly, until my mother's passing in 2011, because she was receiving his two pensions and would have lost them, if it was revealed that my father disclosed secret and classified information. I did have some private conversations about this situation with the late Jim Mayers, who flew to Phoenix to meet me in secret, so we could compare notes. Also, the late Bill Pollack, CIA, a close friend, and Vance Davis, another close friend, knew what I knew. After my mother's passing, I began to open up, and I first revealed all on Doug Hagman's show, and then here on the Common Sense Show. It is clear to me that Trump is transferring the control of the secret space program from deep state to elected government. However, he is doing so under the ruse that the program is one under development, instead of the truth that this is a direct transfer of oversight. Make no mistake about it, this is a direct stab at the deep state, who has controlled this program for its own purposes and profit. Personally, I am surprised that Trump has gotten this far with this bold move, without JFK type of consequences. People might be wondering, where is the proof for the existence of this program, besides the word of the people cited in this report, as well as the reporting of what my father told me? I attended an invitation-only meeting, at the home of Bill Pawlik, see Stephen Greer Disclosure Project. The meeting was held in the foothills of the Sandia Mountains, north of Albuquerque, New Mexico, in 1997. It was at this meeting, and 12 years after the passing of my father, that I witnessed the manifestation of his work in Operation Paperclip. I had privately revealed to Bill what I knew about the secret space program. Bill was fully aware, as a CIA contract agent, he worked with my father in his last duty assignment in Westminster, CO, at Sundstrand Electric. Bill knew my father. Bill Pawlik played video clips that had been captured from the space shuttle automatic camera. What I saw at this meeting is why NASA no longer plays live feeds from space. I witnessed two craft firing on each other with what appeared to tracer, light beam type of weapons. Those of you who are familiar with various STS missions, which have aired on network TV in UFO documentaries, will have a vague idea of what I was shown. I further saw a large pulse beam of light, fired from South America and watched as it passed by the space shuttle's camera. The year was 1997 and is the stuff of science fiction. And please remember, the internet was just getting started and there was no YouTube. There will be those that believe that this program is about defense, not just of America, but of the planet from outside forces. That was not the opinion of my father. He saw the secret space program of being one that pitted America against the Soviets, and any and all future players. However, this view does reflect what Jim Mars, Vance Davis, and Bill Pawlik believed. This article, "Trump Brings the Secret Space Program Out into the Open, Is Disclosure Next?" was originally published on The Common Sense Show, and syndicated by The Event Chronicle. Via SGT Report. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word, and make a difference, by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware, and stay safe.